for those of us who are celebrating our Golden Jubilees, the 8th of June 1968, when we processed into the cathedral for ordination. A great day under a crystalline sky, like the weather we're having at the moment. We salute the present. It is good to be here after 50 years to meet again. Band of brothers, we've been called, and to remember our friends who have gone to the Lord. In the past weeks, people have asked me, what were the highlights? I'm not sure that highlights would be the correct terminology. But all of us have significant moments. Moments that were formative and maybe defining moments. We all have them. And it's good to remember them in days like this. We all have them. Different for all of us because our ministry has covered a wide canvas. But it's good to reflect on them. I can remember three in my own journey. The first one was when I started marathon running. It was strange, but I enjoyed those years, and they were very formative too. Because there I learned about the importance of participation over winning. I used to be terribly competitive. Remember those leagues and things that we had? You know, like winning was so important. But in a field of 20 or 30,000 runners, winning was not going to happen. So the joy and privilege of taking part took on a new meaning. And I suppose the importance of celebrating that. The second one I would identify is meeting Jean Vanier. And through him, the call to work with people who have disabilities. And there I learned in a new way about the importance of all the gifts. There too I was able to accompany and affirm people who were frustrated because they couldn't participate, because society didn't think that they had any gifts that were important. The Western world in particular forgot that the human being is made up of head and hands and heart. And we put all the emphasis on the head and the hands because they were associated with efficiency and productivity. They were the sought after gifts. And maybe we forgot about the heart. We went for the effective rather than the affective side of us. But in reality, the gifts of the head and the hands are only of value to the extent that they serve the heart. A world without heart is a hard, competitive, ruthless world. It is a world without love or emotion. It's not a happy world. It's not a nice place in which to live. And the third defining moment for me was taking some time out and going to Boston College. Thank you, Tommy. That was 25 years ago now. And it was a time, I suppose, to reflect on those things, things really connected with pastoral ministry, and maybe reflecting on how to be in touch with the human story, because ministry is real when it is born out of the human story. And we embrace the future. We did that too in 1968, encouraged by people like P.J. Brophy. Not how exciting times. We'll be saying that the rostrum there. The place was full. Vatican II was coming to an end. A giornamento was on the way. Did we miss the opportunity? Some of us would say we did. Carlo wasn't perfect, but it did have something. Come in, Michael, come in.
Come in, come in.
Mm-hmm. did have something that was different. I was talking to somebody last week who was ordained in another institution in 1967, and he said that went back to a reunion like this, it was like taking 1967 and plonking it down in 2017. And I don't think you'll find that here. It had kind of had something different. I remember La Ryan getting hold of the document, The Church in the Modern World. He got hold of it in Latin before it was actually published. And that made a huge impression on us. And maybe it defined our style in ministry. But we must embrace the future with hope, because the Gospel of Jesus has a beautiful message for the world. My yoke is easy, he said. My yoke is easy. Using an agricultural metaphor from his time. My yoke is easy, meaning it rests easy on the shoulders of the animal. It fits well. And when the disciples asked him, where do you live? They were asking, where are you at home? And he invited them into his house. The home is the safe place. We are drawn to the place that we call home. And the human being is at home with the message of Jesus. We are at ease with it. It suits us. It is a good way to be human in the world. A good way to live. To be, how would you put it in one of your books, Tommy? In a right relationship with ourselves, or God, and our world. So Jesus had that beautiful song for the world. Remember when we were here, remember we used to have those films, once a month or something on a Saturday evening. One of them I remember was The Singer, Not the Song. And I remember that well. But here it's the song that's important. And maybe in the church we put too much emphasis on the singers. We've had some wonderful singers, but some poor ones as well. And that's inevitable, because we are human, and humanity is always a mixture of strengths and weakness. Life is a marriage of the two. But the psalm is beautiful. It speaks of love, of dignity, forgiveness, respect. So stay with the psalm and sing it if you can. The church of the future needs to be different, and I pray that it will. It needs to be more inclusive. It needs to recognize all the gifts and understand that the Spirit of God is in all the baptized. Maybe in the past we preached too much and our preaching was too dogmatic. I sometimes think when I'm on holiday back in the Dingle Peninsula and looking out across the water at the Skelligs, that place from where